Dear friends, welcome to AS American English Center. You have come here to American English Center. Here, we help you to speak English clearly, confidently, phonetically. So here, we teach IELTS and TOEFL, call center training, personality development, GRE, GMAT and TOEFL. So coming here, just an introduction of the communication. The first and foremost, what you have to know, what you should be specialized is to speak clearly, right? This is what the communication is all about. In IELTS, you have a speaking task. So anywhere, wherever you go, during the time of interview, during the time of group discussion, when you want to give presentation, when you want to take the orders, when you want to give orders, it is the communication which plays an important role, right? Indians, we don't use our lips, we don't use our tongue, we don't use our teeth, just like that, you know, just keep pushing the words out. We have to make use of all the systems of the organs of speech. What are the organs of speech? It is the mouth, teeth, nose, throat, then what else? Tongue, then roof of your mouth, isn't it? So here, there are alphabets. How many alphabets are there? 26 alphabets are there, consonants and vowels, right? So the words which are, the sounds which are produced through your lips, it is called unvoiced. And the sounds which are produced from your throat is called voiced, right, sir? Are you clear? So the first unvoiced letter, see, P. P stands for people, isn't it? P. So how do you pronounce P? It comes from your lips, isn't it? Same. When you want to say through the lips, say through your throat. It becomes voiced, B. See, B, 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 P, B, 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 comes from throat. There is a vibration in your throat. Can you feel it? So P, poor, people. When you use same PU produced from your throat, then it becomes voiced, right? B, 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 boy, bat. Ball. So P is unvoiced, B is voiced, P, B, right? Second, T. See, T is produced from your lips, isn't it? See, T, 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 teacher, two, Tamil. So there is no any throat vibration. Same T, T is produced from your lips. Same T, you try to produce it from your throat. What happens? D, D, D. See, T is T, T, T. D is D, D, D. Dog. D. Mm, dog. Then what else? Any other word? Do. Then drama. Then door. D, D, D. So T is T, T, T. D is D, D, D. Same T. The sound you are producing from your throat, it becomes voice, right? These are the partners. So T and D. Next is F. F, how do you produce F sound? Fish. Farmer. Same. Say through your throat, it becomes V. V. Very. Vast. Every. So F is sound. Same F sound you are producing from your throat, it becomes v, 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 right? Next is SH. Sh, 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 should. Shall. Sh, sh, sh. Same sh, sh, sh. You produce through your throat, it becomes what? Ch. Sh, 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 j. Sh, sh, j. Sh, sh, j. Then K. How do you produce K? Cat. Same K, when it produced, the sound is produced through your throat, what happens? G. G. God. G. g, k, g, k, g, right, sir? Then s is produced through your lips. S, sister. S, small. S, San Francisco. S, same s sound when you produce through your throat, it becomes what? Z, zebra. Z, s, is from your lips. Z, is from your throat. Then R, is it voiced or unvoiced? R is produced from your throat. See, R. Ah, how do you say R? You say ah, then open your mouth, make it in round shape. Ah, woo, woo, ram, ruby, river, rrr. So round your lips, and what you do? Push out the sound. You're not taking the sound inside, you're pushing out the sound outside, right? Ah, where? Where are you? Right? Ram, river. So you're pushing out your R sound, right? R. And W, how do you pronounce W sound? W, same, just like how you produce R sound. Make your lips to come into that shape, ooh, right? How do you give a kiss? Like, ooh, right? Fish mouth, ooh. But you, unlike R, you're not pushing it outside, you are pulling it back, right? Where, what, when, 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 where. But R, you're pushing out. But W, ooh, R, you're pushing it back. When, where, which, why? Got it, sir. So, R and W plays an important role in your speech. Then comes L. How do you pronounce L? You pull the jaw down. Open your mouth. L, down. Pull your jaw down. L, L. Umbrella, umbrella. Right? Lila, Lila. So, you just pull your jaw down, open your mouth, and the tip of the tongue should go up. Then you relax and push it down, then you get the L sound. So TH, this TH. But when you want to make a voice TH, it becomes what? With the, them, those, these. That, leather, brother, father, so it becomes voiced. It comes through your throat. Are you getting it, sir? So all the A, E, I, O, U, it all comes through your what? Voiced or unvoiced? From your throat or from your lips? Definitely it should come from your throat. So it's all voiced. A, E, I, O, U, both. It is tensed and it is also lax. What do you mean by tensed and what do you mean by lax? Tense means you are pulling. C, H, I, T, hit. It is lax. Tense means you are pulling the word, enlarging the word. So these are some of the most important things which you need to know in your spoken English, right? So the words, how are they produced? How are they pronounced? All the nouns, all the verbs, all the adjectives, all the adverbs, they are called content words. What do you mean by content words? Important words. So these important words should be highly stressed, right? And what are the functional words? And is, are, then, to, for. All the prepositions. What are the prepositions? To, on, in, for. They are called prepositions. What are conjunctions? And, because, for, because then what else? But. So these are conjunctions. So pronouns, he, she, it. Pronouns, preposition, conjunctions are called functional words. These functional words shouldn't be stressed. What should be stressed? Content words. What do you mean by content words? It is the noun and verb and adverb and adjective. These are content words. Content words should be highly stressed. Functional words should not be stressed much. See, I am coming from Chennai. I am coming from Chennai. Which is the content word here, sir? Could anybody tell? I am coming from Chennai. Chennai is the content word. So content word should be stressed more. I am from. It should not be stressed. I am from. Say, I'm from Chennai. Chennai should be stressed more. Is it so? So what's your name?
Anburaj.
Huh? Anburaj. So Anburaj comes from Chennai. So what are the content words here? Anburaj is a noun. Comes is a verb. Chennai is a noun. So Anburaj comes and Chennai should be stressed more. Anburaj comes from Chennai. So from is functional word. From is not stressed. But Anburaj comes from Chennai. Chennai should be stressed. Anburaj should be stressed. Comes should be stressed. Right? These are called content word. What do you mean by the content word? Then one other word is the focus word. What do you mean by focus word? See, I love you. What is that word? What is the phrase? I love you. One sentence, isn't it? So when you focus on I love you. What do you mean by that? I love you. I love you, not my brother. I love you. When you stress on love, what happens? When you focus on love, what happens? I love you. I don't hate you. When you focus on you, I love you. What do you mean by that? When I focus on you, it becomes I love you, only you, not your brother or sister. I love you and not your family members. So content words, functional words, focus words. You should know what are these words. And according to these words, you have to stress. Right? Once you start stressing and unstressing, what do you mean by unstressing? All the functional words should be unstressed. All the content words should be stressed. All the focus words should be stressed. So you should find out what are the important words should be stressed. What are the important words should be given importance, or we should highlight. The words which you highlight, it becomes your focus word, right? See, for example, I came here to American Center to learn English, right? So which is the focus word? Focus, very important word. I came here to American English for learning English. What is the most important word? Learning English, isn't it? I came here for learning English. For learning English. For speaking English. So these words, the focus words, should be highly emphasized. Very much stressed. The voice modulations, these are called intonations. Stressing the word, unstressing the word. The word should go up, it is called peaks. And the words which are coming down, the sounds which are coming down is called valley sounds. So peak sound and valley sound. Then syllable. Each and every vowel, what it has? It has its own sounds, it gives a sound. See, for example, days. What are the days are there? Sunday. Let us start with Sunday. Sunday, how many vowels are there? Two vowels, isn't it? Yes. U and A. Sunday. Sunday. Two vowels are there. So you have to give two beatings. Ga, ga. So Sunday to Saturday. Or Sunday to Monday. You have to give stress on the first syllable, right? Say everybody together. Sunday.
Sunday.
Monday.
Monday.
Tuesday,
Wednesday,
Thursday,
Friday,
Saturday,
Sunday.
See, in these syllables, the first syllable is stressed, right? In the same way for months. See, January, February, all has three syllables. So the first syllable should be stressed. January, February, March, April, May. June, July. July, you have to stress on second syllable for only for July. July. So three syllable. August, September. Three syllable means the center syllable should be stressed. September, October, November, December. verb, right? The same should be stressed. The second syllable should be stressed. Dear friends, you must be knowing, you must be learning, you must be understanding, you have to understand where the syllable should be stressed. Is it on the first syllable or second syllable or third syllable? For all the nouns, you have to stress on the first syllable. For all the nouns, you have to stress the first syllable. For all the verbs, you have to stress the second syllable. For example, what is your name, gentlemen?
Haji Mohammed.
Haji Mohammed. Haji Mohammed. Five syllable are there, right? So first you have to stress on Ha. Haji Mohammed. My name is Haji Mohammed. Haji Mohammed understands. The verb stand should be stressed more, right? Because understands is a verb. Haji Mohammed. Haji. It is a noun. So noun, the first syllable should be stressed. And for verb, the last syllable should be stressed. Certain syllables you have to unstress. For example, for, F-O-R. For is a preposition, isn't it? So you have to leave out syllable. For. For is changes into for. You don't stress on the vowel, right? Okay, with this we shall continue our class. Thank you very much, sir. After that, we shall go in for some other session, right, sir? Okay. And now, before that, one minute. Why don't you come forward and tell what you are able to understand? Come, gentlemen. Come up. Yes. Okay, why not you? Come up and say what you are able to understand. Next. Yeah. Yes, what you are able to understand.
Good evening, Ananda. In this session, I just learn about the sound pronunciations towards it. When the sound comes around towards the which pathway through that tongue or mouth, like that. So it must be easy to help. It helps me to pronounce it for the more session.
I request Brahma, why don't you come forward and tell what you... Okay, I request Vanita to come forward. Okay, you, why don't you come forward? Why don't you, gentlemen, come forward and tell what you are able to understand? Yes, so you are going abroad, isn't it?
Yeah, sure.
Which country are you planning to go? Please come forward.
You come.
Okay, you can come forward and tell what you are able to understand. Come, be sportive. Brahma also, you can come, take part, yes. Come next, Brahma, be ready. Never feel shy about you. I come here to learn, isn't it? You have to tell what you are able to understand. Yes.
Hi, I'm Raja. I strictly understand the pronunciation. The sound, where it comes from, throat or lips. That's very helpful in the session for me. Word pronunciation, for vowels in front of the word.
Good. Say.
Yeah, pronunciation, I really know how the word pronunciation.
Okay, good. Brahma, please come forward. I'll just give you a few words. Let us see how do you say. Oh, okay.
So, shall I leave, sir?
Yes. Brahma, I just ask you to pronounce these words. Why, which, when, what, why, wish, way, wing. See, whenever W comes, what you have to do is make your mouth in a round shape, right? Ooh. And pull it back. When, where, which, why, wha, right? Okay, start. When, which, where, yes, why,
Why.
Why.
Which.
When.
What.
Wipe.
Wish. Wait.
Wing. Good. And I request, yes, Vanita, you can come and I'll give you certain words. You can just tell, come, don't feel shy. Come, it's very easy.
Thank you.
K and W joins together to give Q. K and W joins together to give Q. Right? Question. Quack. Quite. K plus W. Queen.
Qualify.
Yes.
White.
Quit.
Which.
Yes. Quilt.
Quilt.
Choir.
Choir.
Question.
Question.
Very good. And I request, yes, you young lady to come forward. Nothing wrong. Okay. Well, you can say R. See, whenever you want to say R, you round your lips. See, R, U, U. Push it out. Right? For example, R-O-C-K. Rock.
A rip. Rock. A rich. Road.
Good.
Rain.
Rain.
Rich.
Good.
Room. Rise. Robe. Arise.
Good, good. Take your seat, take your seat. Thank you very much, Vanita. And yes, why don't you, gentlemen, come forward? Please come. And one other student here, please come forward.
You also come.
Yeah, both of you, please come. Both of you, please come. Both of you, please come. Come up to the stage. You also can come. Come. Come, come, come. See, wherever this R comes, what you have to do is, what we have seen about is R, isn't it? Now, whatever you see here, T-H-E-Y, whenever T-H comes, V, how do you say? They, T-H-E-Y, them, there, this, those, these, right? Start.
They. Then.
Them.
There.
There.
Dish.
This.
Those.
Those.
Dish.
These. See, TH comes in between. So, clothing.
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 Leather.
Leather.
Mother.
Mother.
Another.
Another.
Weather.
Weather.
Northern.
Northern.
You got it, sir? So whenever TH you find, you have to, what do you have to do? Okay, next you gentlemen, for you. F, wherever you find F, but wherever you find V, you have to bite your lower lip. See, feel, say.
Feel.
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 Safe.
Safe.
Save.
Save.
Fat.
Fat.
Vat.
Vat.
Fine.
Fine.
Wine.
Wine.
Face.
Face.
Vase.
Vase.
Fan.
Fan.
Van.
Van.
Foul.
Foul.
Vowel.
Vowel.
Proof.
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 Proof. Right? For all F. For all V. Right? So all these sounds, only when you generate these sounds, your English will be perfect English, right? Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Dear friends, as we have seen, as we have told, as we have spoken, all the content words should be stressed, right? And all the functional words shouldn't be stressed. See, for example, content words. What are the content words? It is, for example, noun, right? Let us start with a noun. What is a noun, sir? What do you mean by noun? See here, noun. The content words are noun. Number two is verb. Number three is adjective. Number four is adverb, right? So these are the content words, right? Content words. For example, one word, can you say love? Love is a noun or a verb? Noun is a love, love is a, which part of speech does it belong to? Is it noun or a verb? Love. What is verb? Once again, love. What is adjective for love? Lovely. What is the one other adjective? Lovable. Lovable. What is the adverb for lovely? Anybody? Lovingly. Lovingly. Can you form a sentence using noun? Love as a noun. Anybody? Any one of you? Yes, love is great. Love is God. Love is great. Love is great. So which is in, see, love is a noun, so you have to stress on this word. Love is great. Can you form a sentence using love as a verb? Yes. I love my country. I love my country. So it is a verb. I love my country. So what is the function of love? It has present tense, past tense, and future. Lovely. Can you form a sentence using lovely? Huh? Yes, you are saying something. She is a lovely girl. She is a lovely girl. So can you form a sentence using lovable? Right? Village people are lovable, or Indians are lovable. Indians are lovable. Indians are lovable. Anybody, can you say, form a sentence using lovingly? Lovingly. Yes, Brahma. I request you to say a sentence using lovingly. The word lovingly in a sentence. Anybody over here? Lovingly. Very basic word. Lovingly. Oh. Huh? She spoke to me. She spoke to me. How did she speak to me? She spoke to me lovingly. She spoke to me lovingly. So lovingly becomes adverb, right? So love is a noun, just like a card, just like a pencil. Love is great, right? My card is good. Love is great. And coming here, love, it has the present tense, past tense, and future. I love my country. I love my country. I will love my country. And adjective. She is a lovely person. It qualifies the noun. She is a lovable person. Lovingly. It says about the verb. What is that? She spoke to me lovingly. She spoke to me lovingly. So unless you are good at forming sentences using noun, using verb, using adjective, and using adverb, this is called vocabulary power. This is called derivatives. Same word can be converted using certain changes in the prefix or suffix. The same word can change into noun to verb and verb to adjective. See, love, for an adjective it changes to what? L-Y-A-B-L-E. All the word ending with A-B-L-E is adjective, right? All the word ending with L-Y is an adverb. Lovable, lovingly, lovely. So, this is the most important part here. So, the content words are, which you have to stress are noun, verb, adjective, and adverb. For noun, you have to stress the first syllable. For verb, you have to stress the second last syllable. For adjective, you have to stress the first syllable. For adverb, you have to stress the last syllable. Got it, sir? Say, any other word can anybody say? Brahma, can you come forward and write? I'll tell you. Please come. I'll give you a simple word. Please come forward. Please come. I'll tell you. Now I am going to give a word and she is going to write and tell. See, for example, I'll give you, please have this pen. Beauty as a noun, beauty. Can you form a sentence using beauty? Beauty. Can you form a sentence using beauty? Anybody over here? Beauty as a noun. Yes, Brahma, can you form a sentence using beauty? Beauty. Yes, can you form a sentence using beauty?
Hello.
Yeah, have this mic. Look at the camera and say, beauty. Can you form a sentence using beauty?
Beauty is good.
Huh? Nature is beauty.
Yes.
My son is beauty. My baby is a beauty. The nature. Himalayas is a beauty. Taj Mahal is a beauty. Write it down. Taj Mahal is a beauty. Is a beauty. Is a beauty. Okay, beautify as a verb. Beautify. Write it down. Beautify. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-Y. Beautify as a verb. Can anybody form a sentence using beautify as a verb? Anybody? It has to have present tense, past tense, and future. See, beauty, the suffix T-Y. Here the suffix is I-F-Y. It becomes a verb. Can you form a sentence? I beautify my house. Write it down. I beautify my house. I beautified my house. I will beautify my house. What do you mean by that? You got it? I beautify my house.
I beautified my house, I will beautify my house. Then beautiful, write it down, beautiful as an adjective, beautiful. Beautiful as an adjective. Yes, beautiful. Can you form a sentence using beautiful? My daughter is beautiful. Write it down. My daughter is beautiful. So, word ending with F-U-L is an adjective. Word ending with F-U-L is an adjective. Beautiful. Then coming here, beautifully as an adverb. Word ending with L-Y as a suffix. It becomes an adverb, beautifully. Can you form a sentence using beautifully? My daughter dances beautifully. Write it down. The heroine dances beautifully. The heroine dances beautifully in the movie. The heroine dances beautifully in the movie. Got it? So these are the content words. Whenever you find noun, verb, adverb and adjective in a sentence or when you want to speak, give stress and speak. You have to focus on that word. So that is the reason it is called content words. Right, sir? Now, you write functional verbs. See, functional words. Can you say about some functional words? Number one. Yes. Functional words. Number one. Write it down. F-O-R. How do you pronounce F-O-R?
For.
Fur. You have to stress fur. So for functional words, you should not stress on the vowel. For is changed into fur. Second word you write F-R-O-M. 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 Look at the audience, look at the camera and say, how do you say F-R-O-M?
From.
From. From. Not from. From.
From.
From. From. From. Okay, next. Third, you write because. B-E-C-A-U-S-E.
Okay.
How do you stress? Sure. Let the word be seen in the camera. Because. How do you
because.
Stress?
Because.
Cause. Cause. You have to say?
Because.
Cause. Okay. Now, A-N-D. A-N-D. It is a functional word. A-N-D. How do you say?
And.
Only N. Coffee and tea.
And.
No and. N. Only N. Coffee and tea. N, N,
N.
No D sound, only N. Coffee and tea. Ram and Rahim.
Okay, N.
I and my brother. I and my brother. N, my brother. I and my brother. Only N should be pronounced, right? Okay, fifth, you write it down. T O.
Two.
How is pronounced T O?
Two.
To my house. Not to my house. To my house. I go to my house. I go to my house. To. So all these functional words, you have to unstress the vowel, right? For all these nouns, verb and adjective and adverb, these are called content words where you have to stress. You got it, sir? Are you clear? Thank you very much.
Okay, my name is Rajamanikam. I have been doing this teaching English as my profession for the past 18 years, 13 years in Chennai and 4 years in my hometown. It is called Pollachi in Coimbatore district. Yes. See, I get people from different parts of world, different parts of India, different parts of Tamil Nadu, people of rural background and city background, students who have studied in well good educated in good colleges, schools, English medium schools, and people who come from Tamil medium or regional language as their language which they have learnt. So for the people, different category of people come here. So what I do is, I want to make sure that everybody become an expert in English. And I am a person who don't believe there's a time frame of learning English. You cannot, and it's impossible for anybody who doesn't know the basic foundation in English to learn English within a span of 1 month or 2 months or 3 months. So we, in our institution, we have made around 3,000 videos in corporate English, in grammar, in personality, in group discussion, interview, and meditation, philosophy, HR, and all type of English programs we have recorded and we give to the students. We have made around 10 books. So it is a lifelong learning process. That's what we say to the students, whether they come from English medium or whether they come from Tamil medium. So whoever it is, we give only here this IELTS and TOEFL, where they have a time frame, you know, 1 month or 2 months, they have to write the examination. And based on their examination score, they have to get admission in America or whichever country they want to go, where IELTS is an eligibility score. For them, the time frame is there. For all others, it is English learning, a lifelong English learning program. Yes, sir.
How important is English for employment within India? How important is English pronunciation and English skills that are very much needed in today's government?
Yes, as you know, what is English? English, you know, one Mahatma Gandhi, without English is nobody. Mother Teresa, whether it is in social life, whether it is in political line, whether it is in business line, religious line, or whichever line is, without communication you are nothing. So to come up in life, the communication is the most important, isn't it? That's what. And everybody knows the importance of English. Any parent, not only in Tamil Nadu, in India, nobody wants their children to learn the first language in their mother tongue. It's a true fact. Any parent, politicians alone, they say they want everybody to learn whatever the subject is through their mother tongue. But all the parents, they wish and they want their children to be specialized in English, because it is the one passport or visa, you can say, to have a what type of life? A secured and safety oriented, and something which they get connected all around the world. So English, the importance of English, everybody knows it. That's the reason they come here. That's the reason we go outside and teach people in corporate circles. And generally the people who learn their language, who learn their subject through their mother tongue, they find it very difficult. And in fact, many are feeling inferior to other students who can speak English. Technically, the other students who are good in English, they may not be technically strong, but this particular person, whoever, you know, whose mother tongue, who has learned everything in his mother tongue, but in technically he may be strong, but he is not able to compete with the other person in the job market. That is the scenario. That is the real scenario which we find here. Yes. See, as obviously it is very clear, sir, the students who come from government schools, the students who come from corporation, municipality and panchayat schools, the teachers are not giving importance for English. But in private schools, in matriculation, in ICSE syllabus oriented schools, the private schools, they give much importance for English. That's what the government policy is, that they have to go give importance to the regional language. No other go. It is a vote bank policy. They cannot do anything. They cannot say, no, from today onwards everybody should learn only in English. It is not possible. Even West Bengal, Brahma knows it. You know why? That's what most of the companies are not going to West Bengal. Because what? Uttar Pradesh, in Bihar, they want to give importance to their language. But here, it's all government policies. Vote bank policies, the government cannot do anything. Everybody, if they want to learn, they think that learning English is their life. No, but it is a must to survive, to get a good job, to get a salary of 5 digit. Then it's a must for you to learn English. It is the corporate language. And now people understand and they want to do something. So there is no uniformity of learning English. Each school differs, each town differs. Different schools are there. Priorities are different.
So since it's obvious that more and more people are learning English, so how do you see India from 20 years from now? How do you see India changing its dynamics of language?
Yes, for the past 20 years you've found many of Indian companies have become so worldwide popular, so worldwide famous. Whether you take Infosys or Wipro or TCS, any company, you know, all competing internationally, and you find lot many companies coming here, whether it is American company, Microsoft, IBM, or you find British companies. So many companies are coming here and there, and now, in after 20 years, I'm sure most of the Indians, now presently it is rated that the second highest populated population who speaks English is India, right? Earlier they had a, you know, research and they found. So in sooner we are definitely going to come into number one position, and that is the reason we get all the call center jobs here. The same language, people are able to communicate. The salary which they give there and here, they get lesser, you know, with the lesser salary, they get a lot of workforce. So they give the employment over here. So 20 years by now, I'm sure Indians are hard workers. Indians are tremendously, they want to learn a lot. And in America, you find the second highest population of students who come to America and learn are Indians, especially from Andhra Pradesh. Sooner you can find a lot of people going here and there, and the people mastering in English. Once Britishers made us as slaves, and now we are mastering their language, and we are capturing both industries and offices and whatnot, all the sectors, service sectors. No, this is a statement I think which you are giving. You ask any parent whether they like their son to study in Tamil, if it's Tamil Nadu, Tamil medium, or Hindi. No parent will like their son or daughter to study in regional language. None of the parent. So there is nothing like, you know, everybody wish. Nobody is wishing. Nobody is willing to make their son to study in their regional language. Everybody knew the importance. Everybody has suffered. Everybody knew only by good communication you can climb the ladder of success in any field, corporate or any field. See the daughters and sons of Tamil medium people, when they go for job market, when they go in for campus interview, they are rejected, and it is the pain they're suffering, both the parent and the student. And do they think they will make their son and daughter to study in their own regional language? Definitely no. They want their son and daughter to study in English or French, or in fact even China, they want to go in for China. So learning Tamil or Hindi, what economical benefits do they derive? What economical benefit they get? So it is something suicidal, committing suicide by learning your, what is that, regional language. That's the thing, I think so. Thank you very much, my dear friend. Thank you.